the 100th anniversary of the 60th. We talk about the significance, the design of this machine, the DNA of this machine. It still threads through today with our products.
Absolutely.
This was a game changer, and everyone knew it was a game changer.
So how was this a modern day machine? You could say that this is the equivalent of the D8 today. The undercarriage, the tracks, the systems that our machines kind of run on today all come from C.L. Best and from this machine. He knew manufacturing, he knew design, and he knew how to make a quality machine.
Hi everyone, Rusty Dunn here again, and history just keeps on happening here with my friend and colleague, Lee Fosberg, head of the Corporate Heritage Services and our corporate archivist. Good to see you again, Lee.
Thanks, Rusty.
We've got a significant anniversary coming up. Tell us what we're celebrating. Mm-hmm.
Rusty, we're celebrating the 100-year anniversary of this machine. Two companies merged to form Caterpillar in 1925, one the Holt Manufacturing Company. The other one was the C.L. Best Tractor Company. C.L. Best became our first chairman at the time of the merger.
Yes.
And he created a machine of, you would say, like high quality, very similar to our brand promise today. I'll make a high quality, maybe a little more expensive machine, but it'll pay for itself through time because of how it's built.
So he comes out with the 60. What sort of reaction was there to this machine?
Well, the world started to change when this machine came out. You know, for example, before, the majority of our machines were used for agriculture, right? That's how the track type tractor invented by Benjamin Holt. That's what he used it for.
A farming application that's common.
Because of the durability and the horsepower and the strength behind it was really one of the first successful machines pushing dirt. And that's why we have these great stories of it working on these great and grand projects of the era, because it could do that. It had that kind of power behind it. These machines were used to build like Hoover Dam. They were used to build the Zuider Zee Canal. They were a global product. They worked on projects. They built roads, well documented in India. They built roads in China. These tractors, which we have some great photos of, they actually brought the letters of the Hollywood sign in Hollywood.
Seeing that photo. That's a really famous photo for us. This was really the future. This laid the foundation for the company that we know today.
Absolutely. This was what you would call a game changer. And it really tells the story of not only C.L. Best, our first chairman, but also talks about innovation and our modern tractor line, you know, of the D-series tractors. Kind of a funny story. It's like, you know, we've talked about like the track type tractor. Holt invented the first kind of model, this first test model, 1904. You know, the first gas models were coming out in 1908. So when this came out in 1919, still, right, this was relatively new technology. Well, Best used to joke before this model that you would sell a tractor to a farmer and you'd run that check to the bank right away before it broke down. Well, this was reliability. These machines, they didn't do that, right? And that made them easily sellable, you know, kind of just like the quality equipment that we put out today.
And do you think in their minds this was the 60 was one of the best things they would ever accomplish?
Absolutely. You know, part of the other little story with this is, right, Cat Diesel, right? We're powered by diesel power today. Well, that came from an idea from Best where he saw in 1915 at a World's Fair, Rudolph's Diesel's engines. And he was like, how can I apply that to one of my machines? Well, after the merger, he was able to do that. And this was our big popular machine. It was, you know, the Cat 60 at that time. So we came out in 1931, really with our first diesel engine on, you would say, the frame of a 60. And to show you how impactful that was, literally 2 years later, we were making over half the horsepower in the United States with diesel power, with Cat engines.
Isn't it interesting with people like C.L. Best? These aren't folks who worked in the office. They were true inventors.
Yes, yeah.
And and you think about the impact still today with our machines.
Well, you know, C.L. Best father, whose name was Daniel Best, he was a master inventor himself. He was in the tractor business. He made those big steam tractors. Well, CL worked for him actually going back to the age of 13. He would go, they were a California company, and he'd go kind of from sales places to sales places, and he kind of learned the business from his dad. He became a head of his dad's plant at the age of 18, but he really had very little education other than he knew he went through some training as a draftsman. But he was, you would say, a hands-on guy.
And we've got still got a few of these machines floating around.
We do. In fact, we have one part of our archives collection. It's actually serial number 351. So it was a first-year production. It's going to be celebrating a 100-year anniversary itself. And it's still out there and runs. And kind of another thing, Rusty, that's really hard to believe. The first machine was sold on June 24th, 1919. That machine actually still exists and runs with a gentleman in California.
Isn't that wild? Mm-hmm. That says something about durability and reliability,
absolutely,
doesn't it?
Absolutely, yeah.
Lee,
yeah.
Thanks so much. The 100th anniversary of the 60, very cool, and we look forward to hearing and seeing more about it. Keep the stories coming. This is good stuff.
We'll keep them coming, Rusty. Thank
Excellent.
You.
Thanks, everybody, for watching. More history being made all the time. We'll talk to you soon.